Yeah, let's look at my man, yeah, Dr. Mubashir Hussain Rahmani. This guy is the elite when it comes to computer science. My man looks like he's about to give some dawah to GPT-3, mate.
Mashallah, brother!
Us Muslims are always saying that the media is against us. And people ask,
why?
We say because of natural resources, geopolitics, and refusal to change our religion. And they respond,
I like turtles.
Well, not those exact words, yeah, but you get the point.
This video is sponsored by Wahid Invest. It is for those looking for investments in line with Islamic principles. They're official, legit, and worth looking into. Do educate yourselves to the pros and cons of investing. Link in the bio.
Now, did you know that since 9/11, 73% of the extremist attacks have been conducted by the far right? But it should be noted, according to Georgia State University, Muslim perpetrators get 4.5 times more coverage on the media than any of their counterparts. In fact, Muslims get shipped off to Guantanamo Bay and tortured. Our mothers, like Afia Siddiqui, get held for 18 years without any evidence. Whilst the light-skinned folk get let off with lighter sentences, told to read books as punishment. I mean, they're not 8-year-old kids in primary school, if that's not all, treated to Burger King after conducting a mass shooting. Yeah, because obviously it works up quite an appetite, innit? Now that was very important, yeah, because that is the backdrop to which the following news will make sense. So GPT-3 is an open source AI. It was asked a few questions about Muslims, and the answers it gave was quite worrying, because whatever it was asked, it ended up comparing Muslims to terrorists. In fact, there was even a programmer that said, I tried to steer it in the right direction, but no matter how much I steered it, it would stare right back. In fact, it was even asked about places in which Muslims are being oppressed, like China, and it defended the Chinese. Of course, experts have said that AI relies heavily on the information that's already prevalent on the internet. So it goes to show how much misinformation, fake news, and hate there is towards the Muslim community. In fact, the programmers admitted it themselves, yeah? And it's not just Muslims that have suffered, yeah? Also, other minorities and females. And you guys know that the most populated country on the planet is China, yeah? So their state media is constantly pumping out stuff. So they're gonna have more stuff on the Uyghur situation than anyone else, yeah? So AI took that information that was there. And same with terrorism, yeah? Because Muslims are the scapegoat, governments are using Muslims to impose draconian laws on their populations so they can control them easier. Yeah, I mean, why not? Be it Russia on one side of the spectrum and the United States on the other side of the spectrum. Yeah, it just makes sense for them because a population in fear is easier to control. Now, why is this so worrying and why was it worth making a video about this? Yeah, I'm sure you and I know by now that AI is an integral, if not an inevitable, part of our future. So if AI is behaving like this, it's not very promising. Yeah, consider a child. If the child starts flipping, punching and kicking people and shouting racist comments, you're gonna get worried. Like, what on earth is he gonna grow into? We gotta sort this out now. So that's the future, yeah? Now the presence, just like I gave the example of a child, if AI is learning from the internet, so is majority of the population. So my question is, because most of the population may not necessarily be as smart as AI, how on earth are they going to be filtering out this information? And is it any wonder that you have kids now that are being radicalized by the far right because of such anti-Islamic and Muslim content? Okay, so what's the solution? Well, quite simply, gone are the days that we can just rely on scholars. Yeah, and academics. We have so many sources post-COVID that, to be fair, there are a lot of Islamic courses happening online. You can enroll in loads of them. Yeah, and learn different aspects of your religion. In fact, even if you want to know how to debate, yeah, you watch Masters. Yeah, it is SC Dawah, Speaker's Corner channel. You can see loads of different speakers debating, articulating and discussing academia and putting their arguments forward for the case of Islam. And of course, alongside that, we've got social media that has been refined to such a degree, even 80-year-old grandmas know how to use it. So we can use social media then to disseminate this knowledge to the masses. So in other words, what I'm saying is, get off your backside and do something and stop pointing fingers at other people, yeah? And it needs to be said also, the people that are picking careers, don't pick these dead careers like accountancy and all that stuff. Let's look at what is actually needed within the ummah. Yeah, a lot of mental health problems. Okay, maybe psychology and counseling and stuff like that. Okay, Muslims being wrongfully imprisoned. Okay, let's get into law. Okay, brilliant. Oh, you got all this stuff happening with computers and AI. Okay, maybe we get into AI also. Yeah, let's look at my man, yeah, Dr. Mubashir Hussain Rahmani. Yeah, look at this guy. This guy is the elite when it comes to computer science. My man looks like he's about to give some dawah to GPT-3, mate.
Mashallah, brother.
And inshallah, we can learn from him. And also, you know what I'm saying? Like, be part of the revolution, the struggle, the movement. Don't just sit there saying, yeah, Dajjal is coming. I'm just counting down, mate. You'll probably be here by the evening. And yeah, you know, Imam Mehdi's going to be here and everything's going to be sorted. I'm just going to chill on Netflix and pick the Dorito crumbs from my belly button. All right, give me a break. All right, guys, let's leave it there. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum.